think all the things you can think if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or gink with a stink, or stare through the sky. If you open your mind, all the things you will find lining up to get loose. All the things you can think when you think about Zeus!
Trip on a ship to the vapor of it, or to Salusalu.
Think a beautiful schlop with a cherry on top.
You don't need an excuse.
All the things you can think when you think about Zeus.
Think of an elephant up in a tree.
Think of a person too tiny to see.
Think of a bird with a one feathered tail
going on adventure down a dangerous trail.
Think of a bird who flies off on a spree.
Think of a kangaroo, sad as can be.
Think of a general crazy for war.
Think of something horrible and hairy.
Something sinister and scary that you've never dared to think of before. Think of nobody here, and the feeling of fear, and the darkness of night. Ooh. All alone in your room, as you're facing your doom.
Think a glimmer of light.
Ah,
but I hope you're prepared to be scareder than scared,
cause it's a Mother Goose.
Danger's right on the brink
when you think about Zeus. Zeus, 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 Zeus. Oh, the things you can think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare. When your things have run dry, in the blink of an eye, there's another thing there. If you open your mind, all the things you will find lining up to get loose. All the things you can think, 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 all the things you can think when you think about Zeus. When you think about Zeus. When you think about Zeus.
Now that is a very unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. It could be a creature, they call it a zat, who balances things on his head because it's flat. Or a stripe-loving pipester from Uppermount Bat. Or a sort of a kind of a hat-wearing cat.
I can see you've got quite a mind for your age. Why, one think, and you've dragged me right onto the stage. Now that I'm here, there's no telling what may ensue with a cat such as me and a thinker like you.
Oh, the things you can think, oh, the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or gink with a stink, or stare through the sky. If you open your mind, all the things you will find lining up to get loose. All the things you can think when you think about Zeus.
Zeus! Zeus! Zeus, 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 Zeus! All the things you can think, any thinker who thinks can come up with a few. Ship on a ship, to the vapor of it, or to Salusalu.
Think a beautiful schlop with a
cherry on top.
You don't need an excuse.
All the things you can think when you think about Suits.
Suits, 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 suits.
Think of an elephant up in a tree.
Think of a person too tiny to see.
Think of a bird with all one feather tail.
Going on adventure down a dangerous trail.
Think of a bird who flies off on a spree.
Think of a kangaroo sad can be.
Think of a general crazy for war.
Think of something horrible and hairy.
Something sinister and scary that you never dared to think of before. Think of nobody here, and the feeling of fear, and the darkness of night. Ooh. All alone in your room, as you're facing your doom.
Think a glimmer of light.
Ah.
But I hope you're prepared to be scarier than scared.
Cause it's a Mother Goose.
Danger's right on the brink.
What do you think about
Suits? An unusual story will soon be unfurled of an elephant trying to save a small world. And a boy from that world who has things just like you.
Just think! From the planet of who?
And the smallest of small.
To the jungle of Newell.
And the largest of all.
You think and you think and 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 think. Just think! Of the things you can think. Think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare. When your things are run dry, in the blink of an eye, there's another thing there. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lighting up to get loose. Oh, the things you can think. Oh, the things you can think. Oh, the things you can think.
Oh, the things you can think.
Oh, the things you can think. When you think about Suits. When you think about Suits. When you think about Suits.
Begins with a very strange sound. The drums of the jungle beginning to pound. Now imagine a sky.
I imagine bright blue.
It's the jungle of Newell, near the river Waloo.
On the 15th of May, in the jungle of Newell, in the heat of the day, in the cool of the pool, he was splashing,
splash,
enjoying the jungle's great joys, when Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant, heard a small noise.
So Horton stopped splashing. He looked for the sound.
That's funny,
thought Horton.
There's no one around.
Then he heard it again, just a very faint yelp,
as if some tiny person were calling for help. I'll help you,
said Horton.
But who are you and where?
He looked and he looked. He could see nothing there.
But a small speck of dust blowing past through the air. I say, how confusing. I've never heard tell of a small speck of dust that was able to yell. So you know what I think? I think that there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Some poor little person who's shaking with fear that'll blow in the pool. He has no way to steer. He's alone in the universe. I'll just have to save him, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
So gently and using the greatest of care, the elephant stretched his great trunk through the air, and he lifted the dust speck and carried it over and placed it down
safe
on a very soft clover.
Hop! Hop the voice! Was the sour kangaroo and the young kangaroos by her side said, hop to why that speck is as small as the head of a pin. A person on that, why there never has been. Ha ha ha! You're the biggest blind fool in the jungle. Who I tell is playing fool in the jungle anew, and I think so as well. Maybe I'm nasty, maybe I'm cruel, but you're the biggest playing fool in the jungle anew.
It's true, please believe me. I tell you sincerely, my ears are quite keen, and I heard him quite clearly. I know there's a person down there, and what's more, quite likely there's two, even three, even four.
Ha! Let the boys!
Ha!
Bless the mothers!
Ha! Ha!
Brothers.
Oh, he's the biggest flame fool in the jungle of Noor, and monkeys like us should know. We've been out on a limb looking down on him,
and he's bad,
dumb, slow.
Elephants ain't too swift as a rule, but he's the biggest flame fool in the jungle of Noor, cause he's talking to his back, to his back at dust.
Flame fool in the jungle of Noor.
R-E-S-P-E-C-K! Oh, please, throw that speck away!
Did you hear? Did you hear? Did you hear?
The news quickly spread.
Did you hear? Did you hear? Did you hear?
He talks to a dust speck, he's out of his head!
Our topic today is psychic elephants that hear voices. What do you think, folks? Is he off and off his trunk? Stay tuned, we'll be right back with Speck, Clover, Dust, Neighbor, Who? Nothing. We'll be right back.
Biggest flame fool in the jungle of Noor.
I'm Gertrude McBuzz, and I live right next door. He's never done anything crazy before.
Biggest flame fool in the jungle of Noor.
He's always been friendly and loyal and kind. I just don't believe Horton's out of his mind.
Did you hear? Did you hear? Did you hear?
I'm Maisie Lovebird, and I live in that tree.
Did you hear?
Enough about Horton. Let's talk about me.
Let's talk about
me.
Talking to his back,
I just have to save them, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how
big. Big flying fool in the jungle of Noor. He's the worst we ever saw. Telling lies, making jokes with an elephant hoax. Rather, that's against the law. Acting as if he's holding a jewel.
Somebody stuck a trunk on a mule.
Biggest flying fool. In the jungle of no, in the jungle of
the 15th of May, Miss Gertrude McFuss discovered how truly unique Horton was. But she knew to approach him would probably fail,
'cause who'd notice a bird
with a one-feathered tail?
Help! Help!
Then the voice came again, calling over and over.
Help!
So he tried to think, who might be down on that clover?
Hello? Is anyone there? Who are you?
We're who's here. We are who's here. Smaller than the eye can see. It's true, sir. We're who's, who's, sir. I'm a who and so is she.
We're tiny little people blowing by in the air, wondering how and why. We're on who, the tiniest planet in the sky.
La 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 la.
Struggling to stay alive. Each gust propels our dust. How the heck do who survive? At any given moment we could crash or be drowned, hitting the ground. Oh my, we're on who? The tiniest planet in the sky.
I'm the mayor.
I'm his wife.
Just imagine the Who's unusual life. Picture the tiniest houses and grocery stores. Tiny umbrellas that drip on the tiniest floors. The tiniest tunnels and tiniest streets. Miniature buses with miniature seats. Miniature buildings with miniature windows and doors.
No smaller town than yours.
Marching bands and a small band. Oh, you want to hear them wail. And the Grinch is here, and every year
I reenact my Christmas tale. Although who's down in Whoville like the holiday season a lot. But the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not.
Imagine a place that is tidy and totally clean.
Where even a Grinch couldn't dare to be totally mean.
You think that it's heaven on earth? Yes, you do. But heaven on earth isn't heaven on who. Troubles on who are the biggest that you've ever seen. We're on the brink of war. They say we're going to war and no more. 'Cause if we do, then here on who? Well, you can give who a goodbye.
Our skies are unbearably dark.
And war is unbearably near.
And that's not the end of our troubles here. For on the other side of town, the Truffula trees were all cut down. They once stood tall in all their glory. But that's another story. So here on who we live in fear, we're drifting through space and cannot steer. A troubled and a tiny land.
people saying thanks in advance, hoping perchance you'll try. Here on Who, the tiniest planet in the sky.
I won't let you down. No, I won't let you fall. A person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
An invisible world, amazing but true. We'll leave Horton to listen, and we'll zoom in on Who. But guess who enters our story now? Who? You!
Meet a tiny Who family on a small rainy day.
Mom and Dad are just home from the Who PTA.
And here's your son, Jojo.
In trouble again. Cause his thing's taken places where no one has been.
I'm the mayor of Who. Why, I've just been elected. And upright behavior is thus forth expected.
But we just had a talk with your teachers today, and they didn't have one single good thing to say.
You invented new things which the file description.
You gave Miss O'Dooley a nervous conniption.
Your things were so wild they disrupted your classes and made Miss McElhoo drop her new glasses, which is why you're suspended. Yes, that's what they said. Young man, what in Who has gotten into your head? Now, Horton has found us. We're safe on a clover. But clearly, our troubles are far, far from over.
Now, we don't mean to scold you. We love you. Oh, yes, dear. But couldn't you try thinking just a bit less, dear?
Stop telling such outlandish tales.
Stop turning minnows into whales.
Now, take your bath and go to bed.
And think some normal things instead.
You got me in trouble. Get out. Go away. All right, I'll be going. Wait, but first let me say... Oh, the things you can
stop.
Think. Oh, the things you can
be
think.
Be quiet.
As you splash and you splish.
I'm not listening.
As you sit there and scrub, have a think in the tub. Think of water and fish.
Fish?
Think of pipes in the floor, heading off to a shore where the water is cool. Soon your tub's not a tub.
It's McGilligan's pool.
This might be a pool like I've read of in books, connected to one of those underground brooks. An underground river that starts here and flows right under the bathtub, and then, who knows, it's possible. Anything's possible. It might go along down where no one can see, right under State Highway 203, right under the wagons, right under the toes of Mrs. Ombroso, who's hanging out clothes. It's possible, anything's possible. It's possible, anything's possible. This might be a river, now mightn't it be connecting McGilligan's pool with the sea? Then maybe some fish might be swimming toward me. McGilligan's pool, it's possible.
It's possible.
It's possible. Anything's possible.
It's possible.
It's possible.
It's possible.
Anything's possible.
overflowed on the floor. The water is running right under the door.
The ceiling is peeling. You flooded the den. Oh, Jojo, I think you've been thinking again.
I say this with firmness and terrible sorrow. Young man, we will deal with you. Come tomorrow.
I still think that I'm not such a fool when I sit here and fish in Miguel Agate's pool. It's possible.
Trouble till this thinking thing began.
We must both lay down the law.
Will he hate us?
Maybe so.
Oh, where are the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has all the answers? I don't know.
Does your child give you troubles? Do his grades keep on shrinking?
Does he drive teachers wild with this uncontrolled thinking?
As a parent, are you
overwhelmed, insecure?
The help that you seek is inside this brochure.
It's nine, sun, rise and shine, sun. It's a very special day.
Get dressed, dear, look your best, dear. Soon you will be on your way.
Now here is your pencil.
Here are your mittens and
here is your sword.
My sword?
General Genghis Khan Schmitz! I scare children out of their wits! But you see, it's a glancer. My school is the answer for shirkers and dreamers and twits. And in this case, I'd say the shoe fits. A 10 hot, and feet together, chin up, eyes on the prize, forward, ha hard! The military academy is the place where he should be sent. We'll drill the silliness from his head. I'm sure we'll make a dent. We'll teach him fighting and left and righting until he's muscled and tan. Art, two, three, he's pathetic. Art, two, three, analytic. Art, two, three, but I'm betting we can. The military, that's what makes a boy a man. The military is extraordinarily good for somebody meek. He'll bump with bullies who'd beat him up
at least 3 times a week.
He'll sweat and shiver and eat raw liver. It's all a part of the plan.
A hot, two, three.
When they suffer,
a hot, two, three.
Boys get tougher,
a hot, two, three.
And it's time he began. The military, that's what makes a boy a man.
Smash, 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 smash.
Our boys believe in the right of every who to their bread. Butter side up!
Butter side up!
One thing we trust on this fragile speck of dust is eating bread. Butter side up!
Butter side up!
And as for those who like their butter down,
down, down, down, down, down,
system and boys soon see nothing's easier than the military. That's what makes a boy.
man! I do not like green eggs and ham.
I do not like green eggs and ham.
I do not like them Sam I am.
I do not like them Sam I am.
Sound off. Sound off. I do not like green eggs and ham.
I've been guarding this clover for over a week, getting laughed at for thinking a dust speck can speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind, for I have found something that they'll never find. There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air, hidden planets, tiny worlds, all invisible. Not a person seems to know. Not a person seems to care. There is no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain at one time or other, great thinkers all feel this way. I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. I found magic, but they won't see it. They all call me a lunatic. Okay, call me a lunatic. If I stand on my own, so be it. 'Cause I have wings, yes, I can fly around the moon and far beyond the sky. Well, someday soon, I know there you'll be. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe who believes in me.
I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. My own planets and stars are glowing.
Alone in the universe.
No one notices anything, not one person is listening. They don't have any way of knowing.
Nobody knows that I have wings.
I have wings.
Yes, I can fly.
I can fly
around the moon and far beyond the sky. Well, someday soon
you will hear my plea.
One small voice in the universe,
one true friend in the universe, please believe in me.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Who's there?
It's me, Jojo, the mayor's son.
I'm Horton, the elephant.
Are you real, or are you a very large think?
Oh, I'm real, all right. I would state that in ink.
In my thinks, I imagine a lot of strange things, and I go to strange places as if I had wings. I love a good think.
Well, that goes for me double.
Sometimes my thinks are what get me in trouble.
When you think, do you dream?
In bright colors.
Me too. And I go to strange places, like Sala Salu.
When you think, do you think it could fly to the stars?
Little friend, no one else could have thinks such as ours.
I have wings.
I have wings.
Yes, I can fly.
I can fly.
Round the moon and far
beyond the sky.
You called my name and you set me free. One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe. Who believes in me?
Good night, JoJo.
Good night, Horton. See you in Sala Saloon.
Over! There's more to be heard. There goes our hero. But who enters? The bird!
Love Song for Horton, number 347. Did you? A girl bird named Gertrude McFuzz, and she had the smallest plain tail ever was. One droopy droop feather, that's all that she had. And oh, that one feather made Gertrude so sad. She curled it, she dyed it, she gave it a puff. She decked it with flowers, but it wasn't enough. For no matter what, it just was what it was. A tail that simply wasn't meant to catch the eye of an elephant. The one feathered tail of Miss Gertrude McFuzz.
Poor little Gertrude. Such a sorry sight. I was once a plain little bird like you, kid. One pathetic feather was all I grew. I had nothing show-offish. What's a plain bird to do? And there's certainly nothing show-offish on you.
Thank you, Maisie.
Then I made a plan for my self-improvement. No more crumbs, I vowed I would have the cake. Yes, I went to the doctor.
Dr. Date by the lake.
And he told me what sort of a pill I should take. Now, I'm Amazing Maisie, as feathered as feather can be now. Amazing Maisie, it was all for sale.
Amazing Maisie,
the birds are all whistling at me now.
Amazing Maisie,
baby, that's my tail.
High or low?
She's fabulous.
Watch her go.
She am envious.
To and fro. Maisie's fabulous tail.
I wish I had one like it.
Left and right.
Best I've ever seen.
Day or night.
Kids, you're turning green.
What a sight. Maisie's fabulous tail.
Get those pills.
Get the pills.
And you can have frills.
Frills. Your Horton is certain to see. And you. Amazing!
Well, almost. As amazing as me!
So she flew to the doctor.
The doctor named Dake.
Whose office was high in a tree by the lake. And she cried, Dr. Dake, oh please, do you know of some kind of pill that will make my tail grow?
Tut tut, said the doctor. The kleiner Finnish was ist in now Hrishkin, wie der Vogelart.
Huh?
In In other words, your little tail is just right
for your kind of bird.
No! Then Gertrude had a tantrum. She raised such a din that finally the doctor just had to give in.
All right already. Bring in the bilberry bush.
What was that?
Something itching me. What was that?
Something switching me. What was that?
Are those feathers I see? I think my tail's beginning. Oh, my word. This is wonderful, second, third. Ooh, I'm colorful. What a bird. I'm beginning to be
amazing, Gertrude. Just look at the tail she is sporting. Amazing, Gertrude.
Thank you, Dr. Dake.
Thanks, Doc.
Amazing, Gertrude. And hopefully I'll impress Horton.
Amazing, Gertrude.
One more pill will do me good. Yes, it will. One more, one more, one more pill.
Soon she'll have the biggest tail. She'll have the biggest tail.
I'll have the biggest tail.
The biggest tail of all.
So Gertrude is happy. Her tail is pretty long.
Kid, fasten your seatbelt, 'cause now things go wrong.
Hello.
Well, it's bigger than a bread box.
Hey, it's flatter than a quail.
Peanut butter bread.
And scared to death from head to tail.
Hey.
So you're still tossing that dust. Oh, that's hot.
A dust bag that's all full of fools who are not.
There aren't any who's. Why, I don't hear a sound.
Come on, we're gonna monkey. Monkey around!
Hey, wait! Stop! Give that back!
Up out of the jungle, up into the sky, up over the mountain,
10,000 feet high,
then down from the mountain,
and into the news, when Horny Elephant chasing the who's, chasing the who's.
This is Cat in the Hat, live from Sky Cam 5. Folks, the jungle of Nu is one heck of a drive. We've got monkeys backed up to 302. I'd find alternate routes if I were you.
Then over the desert of trees, and into the forest with thousands of trees, past beaches on beaches,
and small kangaroos.
Chasing the hoop.
monkeys to trust? Or don't you agree? Well, just to make sure, we're handing it off to a black bottom eagle named Vlad Leghoff! On that late afternoon and far into the night, that black bottom bird flapped his wings in fast flight. And he paid no attention to Horton's loud call.
A person's a person, no matter how small.
Whoa! Whoa!
Wear those hair, wait, are those hair, please don't let us fall.
Whoa!
Wear those hair, wait, could bruise hair, helpless we get small.
Whoa!
Vladikov dropped it, the clover went tumbling, and nobody stopped it. Head over heels, 100 miles down, while the poor little Hoos and their whole tiny town.
When the news is all bad and you're sour and blue, when you start to get mad, you should do what I do. Tell yourself how lucky you are. When your life's going wrong and the fates are unkind, when you're limping along and get kicked from behind, tell yourself how lucky you are.
Ah!
Why decry a cloudy sky, an empty purse, a crazy universe? My philosophy is simply, things could be worse. Achoo!
Ew!
So be happy you're here, think of life as a thrill. And if worse comes to worse, as we all know it will, thank your lucky stars you've gotten this far.
We're here in this beautiful theater, and you're in the first row. How lucky to be in the theater, more lucky than you know. You could have the luck of our hero whose luck has been running low. For certain, he's hurting.
Oh no!
How lucky you are!
That bird let that clover drop somewhere inside a great patch of clovers, 100 miles wide. But I'll find it, I'll find it, I'll find it or bust. I shall find my friends on their small speck of dust, clover by clover by clover with care. I'll listen and call. Are you there? Are you there?
It's taken all my courage to approach you, not to mention all my stamina to follow you across the hills and deserts. But I feel as if I'm ready to confess to you the feelings that I've hidden with great diligence and labor. Behind the facade of your odd little next door neighbor. My eyes are too small. I have very large feet. And I'm not very proud of my pitiful tweet. But I've now got a tail that is something to see.
102,
103. Oh, notice me, Horton, feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me, Horton. Horton together, we could be great. Oh, notice me, Horton, put down the clover. This is your next door neighbor calling. There's a new leaf, your neighbors turned over.
Over and over, clover by clover. I was just a no one only yesterday. You showed up and showed me something more. Now I've become a someone who has someone to believe in and to be there for.
I will not give up hope. I was hooked from the start. When I noticed your kind and your powerful heart. So notice me, Horton.
Well, the world would be something new.
Notice me, Horton.
If they noticed a thing or two.
Notice me, Horton.
The way I noticed you.
$2,999,999. It's hopeless.
You said it, kid.
Who's there?
It's me, Maisie, up here.
Oh, hi, Maisie. Are you on a nest?
Yeah, you want to make something of it?
Oh, no. I just never thought I'd see you on a nest.
Neither did I, Hort. Neither did I. Da 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 da. I was down in Fort Worth, just a girl on the wing. When I met Weed McFirth, oh, could that night I'll sing. Tell yourself how lucky you are. It was 3 weeks of bliss, then the usual seg. He flew off to San Juan, leaving me with this egg. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky you are.
Now I'm bored and I'm cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required? I'd much rather play. I need a vacation. I'm due for some rest. Hey, Horton, would you maybe like to sit on my nest?
Why, Maisie, I couldn't, of all silly things. I haven't got feathers. I haven't got wings. And not only that, but I'm here on a search. I just couldn't leave my poor who's in the lurch.
I won't be gone long, kid. I give you my word. I'll hurry right back, because I'm that sort of bird. Oh, Horton, I promise. I'll fly back real soon. I'd only be gone for, say, one afternoon.
Well, the only vacations. All right, go on, take it. I'll sit in your egg and I'll try not to break it. But please come back quickly. 1 hour, maybe two. I've got to find JoJo. I've got to save who?
Hit it, cat. Thanks. Thanks a million. Toodaloo.
And carefully, tenderly, gently he crept up the trunk to the nest where the little egg slept. Then Horton the elephant smiled.
Well, that's that.
And he sat and he sat and he sat and he sat. He sat all that day and he kept the egg warm. And he sat all that night through a terrible storm.
Cold and I'm wet and I'm catching the flu. Oh, Maisie, please hurry. I've got to save who? Oh, Maisie, please hurry. I've got to save who?
Horton, I brought you a scarf.
Thank you, Gertrude. Have you heard from Maisie?
She sent a card from Palm Beach.
Palm Beach? Oh, Gertrude, what if she never comes back?
Don't worry, she will. Horton, notice anything different?
Yeah, it's getting colder. Nest. No, I meant what I said. The egg might get frozen, but the who's might be dead. I couldn't say no when I heard Maisie beg. Now I'm stuck between a dust speck and an incubating egg. Help! Somebody help! Hunters! Help! When your life's going wrong and you're wondering why.
When your tail is so long you're unable to fly.
Tell yourself how lucky you are.
When you land with a thud and you're bumped and you're bruised.
When you're trapped
and you're grounded
and lost and confused. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
My philosophy is simply things could be worse.
So be happy you're here. Think of life as a thrill. And if worse comes to worst, as we all know it will, thank your lucky star you've gotten this far.
It's time for a brief intermission, which means act one is through. So go have a nice intermission. A lobby for will do. We've got to face up the stage and get ready to play act two.
And tell yourself how lucky you are. How lucky you are. How lucky you are. How lucky you are. How lucky you
are. How lucky you are.
Thank you.
moment you've all been waiting for. Without further ado, presenting Act Two. Our story resumes on that terrible day as Horton gets carried away.
Up out of the jungle, up into the sky, up over the mountains,
10,000 feet high, then down from the mountains and down to the sea, went Horton the elephant, egg nest and tree,
egg nest and tree,
egg nest and tree.
They loaded the wagon right onto a ship, out over the ocean, and ooh, what a trip, rolling and tossing, and sick as can be. Just a seasick elephant, egg nest and tree, egg nest and tree.
After bobbing around for 2 weeks like a cork,
egg nest and tree,
they landed at last in the town of New York.
Egg nest and tree.
He was wet, he was tired and hungry and cold.
Egg nest and tree.
Then Horton was taken to auction.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Susie B's.
Brian,
our first
so
item up to bid this evening is lot 39. A pendulous pachyderm, which is on egg nest and tree. We'll start the bidding at $10,000. Can I hear $10,000? A reasonable price for a creature this size. Fully vaccinated and a lovely singing voice. 10,000, thank you. 10,500. 10,500. 11,000. Ladies and gentlemen, with Valentine's Day approaching, what better way to say I love you than a pet elephant? 11,500, thank you. Can I get 12,000? 12,000. 12,000 anywhere. 12,000, and we'll throw in this lovely set of steak knives and this George Foreman grill. 12,000, thank you. 12,000 going once. 12,000 going twice. Sold to the man with the sideburns and the greasy black mustache. Pardon me, madam. Sold to the man from the circus. On the face of the earth or wherever you go. The Circus McGurkus, in town for 1 week. Each marvelous marvel is just 10 cents a peek. Oh, the sights that you'll see, why our big top is packed. And there's no telling where we may find our next act. Pendulous pachyderm, look, could it be? Who sits on
on an egg in a nest in a tree.
Monstrosities, real curiosities, go where you never have been. The Circus Mugurkus.
The Circus Mugurkus.
The Circus Mugurkus. Come on in.
Come on.
Shark River Hills, Pittsburgh, Dubuque, Maplewood.
When you're jouncing along on a road full of ruts, getting jeered by a throng and performing for nuts, tell yourself how lucky you are. There's a crick in your tail and a cramp in your toes. You're on who knows what trail, and where who is who knows. Tell yourself how lucky you are. I'm worried for JoJo and all of the rest. They're lost in the clover, I'm stuck on a nest. I'll sit on this egg, cause what else can I do? Oh Maisie, please find me, vacation is through. Oh Maisie, please find me, I've got to save food.
Palm Beach!
When you're down in Palm Beach with the breeze in your hair, and you don't have an egg or a nest or a care, tell yourself how lucky you are. When it's day after day after beautiful day to be lazing away by the sea with Renee, tell yourself how lucky you are. Still, I'm bored and I'm cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required for nothing but play? I need something different, I crave something new. Hey, maybe you could give me something different to do. A circus. I love a show. I think I'll go. Good gracious! I've seen you before. Now let's see.
Why, Maisie, it's Horton, remember? It's me! I've sat on your egg now for 51 weeks. I've sat here while people have paid to take peeks. I've sat here through lightning and hailstorms and snow. Won't you take back your egg?
Gee, I really don't know. Oh wow, it's really late. And gee, I've got a date. And lots of places to be, but it's so great to see you. Look at you. Who would ever guess? Look at you. Such a big success, and it's all thanks to me. Amazing Horton, that egg-sitting circus sensation. Amazing Horton, and I'm impressed. Amazing Horton, while I was off taking vacation, you made your fortune up on Maisie's nest. I may be unreliable, fancy-free, irresponsible, crazy me, always eager to fly, but
delight just for once. I've done something right. The egg is all yours. No, don't thank me. I'll cry. Good luck when it hatches. Good luck. And goodbye.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful, 100%. And now, little egg, you're alone in the universe too. Who would have thought you'd be left up to me, a fool of an elephant, up in a tree? Well, this time I swear I'll do better than try. I'll protect you from harm. Yes, I'll do it or die. So rest now, young egg, and I'll sing you a lullaby. There's a faraway land, so the stories all tell. Somewhere beyond the horizon. If we can find it, then all will be well. Troubles there are few. Someday we'll go to Sala Salu. Sala Salu.
Sala Salu.
Dear Mom and Dad, I'm thinking of you and wishing we all were in Sala Salu. They say breezes are warm there
and people are kind.
Maybe it's something like heaven. I close my eyes and I see in my mind skies of bluest blue. Sala Salu.
I've had so much trouble finding my way there. When I get close, it disappears. If we can get there, we're gonna stay there. If it takes us miles,
if it takes us miles,
if it takes us years, high on a mountain or lost on the sea, sooner or later I'll find it.
I have a picture of how it will be. On the day I do, troubles will be through, and I'll be home with you. Sala Salu, Sala Salu, Sala Salu.
Arrived at
this war, as I said that we would, and war is the thing that does every boy good. We'll sleep in the trenches and go without supper to make the world safe for each butter side upper. We'll shoot every traitor and all out-of-towners who side with those bibulous butter side downers. Any questions?
Sir, this war makes no sense. Just one think and you'd quit. Spreading bread up or down doesn't matter a bit. We've crashed in this clover. There's no help in sight. So why are you here teaching children to fight? And not only that, sir, it's Christmas on who? I'd rather have Christmas than war, wouldn't you? So here is my sword and here is my hat. I'm going home and that, sir, is that.
It's a minefield out there. This is no time for play.
Sir, think what I think. Now get out of my way.
Soldier, you will obey. You will halt. Son, wait. Jojo, come back.
With his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so?
It came without ribbon. It came without tag.
It came without packaging.
Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then?
Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day.
And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And
the Grinch carved the roast beast, beast, carved the beast.
Thank you, Mr. Grinch. As always, a wonderful Christmas show. And may I say we're most grateful this year, since we've all had such trouble, much trouble, I fear. We crashed in the clover, things smashed and things tore. Our town is a mess and our planet's at war. But it hasn't stopped Christmas from coming, it came. Somehow or other, it came just the same. So let's make a toast that the war won't arrive here, that Horton will find us, and we all stay alive here.
And here's to our Jojo, our sweet precious son, who's still off at school, and I'm sure having fun.
A message from the front!
Smith, 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 Smith!
In the Battle of Butter, your son has been lost.
Lost?
When the battle began, the young man paid the cost.
Oh, no!
He did not want to fight. He might have been right. Here's his hat. Here's his sword. Regrets and good night.
Our perfect little boy. Salah, salut. Salah, salut.
Wait, could it be that kid did survive? I'll reenact him.
I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the
Horton, where are you and what should I do? I'm lost and I'm frightened and don't have a clue. You said you'd be there if I needed you to. I'm thinking of you.
Follow your nose. Then you have a sudden hunch you should follow your toes. Soon a sneaky hunch is whispering, better go straight. And before you know it, oh, it's so late, 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 late.
Late, 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 late.
Now a nervous hunch is telling you you could be lost.
Lost, lost, lost.
Lead you down a path you have already crossed.
Cross, 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 cross.
Soon you're overwhelmed by hunches that pester and pinch and punch. And you know you're having a hunch.
You're having a hunch.
Galore. You flooded my house, sent me marching to war, filled my head full of things, and now you won't go away!
All right!
I'll be going, but first let me say... Think of nobody here, and the feeling of fear, and the darkness of night.
Ooh.
All alone in your room, as you're facing your doom, think a glimmer of light.
You mean that's it?
That's it. You're a thinker, Jojo, tried and true. I don't often meet thinkers like you.
I want to go home.
And that's easy to do. Just follow your hunches. They'll lead you home to who? A bridge to the shore and a road to your door. You'll be home before lunch.
Oh, the places I'll go if I follow my hunch.
Hunch. Follow your hunch.
Well, that's nothing new. I mean, everyone does. But Gertrude did something that few birds could do. So this is the tale of Miss Gertrude, part 2.
Who's there?
It's me, Gertrude.
Gertrude.
Oh, Horton, I was so worried. Are you all right?
How did you find us?
Well, it's a long story. I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little. It was absolutely giant, and it really was attractive, but you didn't even notice. So I felt a little silly even trying. Besides which, the tail was too heavy for normal flying.
Go on.
Well, when the hunters caught you, I could see that I've been foolish because I couldn't even help you. No, I couldn't even fly. And I got so very frightened because I knew I had to save you. No one else was gonna go through all the labor. It was all up to me. All you had was your next door neighbor. So I ran to the doctor.
The doctor named Dake, and she said,
my tail has been a mistake.
And she said,
Dr. Dake, I've been foolish and vain. Plug it out. Get it off. I won't do it again.
Cluck, cluck, cluck.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Cluck, 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 cluck.
Ooh, a tender spot.
Cluck, cluck, cluck.
Just a one-feathered tail. But suddenly,
Gertrude could sail.
I sailed on a junk and was practically sunk for you. I trampled through the trees full of furious bees for you. I saw through a fog and a choking smog down a soggy slope through a stinking bog while my slip was gripped by a vicious dog for you. I galloped through the snow in 11 below for you. Yes, even though I knew I was catching the flu for you. Achoo! And then came the holler. I caught my soul and I rolled downhill out of all control till I broke my fall on a jagged shoal for you.
I never noticed. You're amazing.
Oh, it was nothing.
Hello? Who's? Hello?
Hello!
Oh, what a relief. Hello, Mr. Mayor. Is Jojo all right?
Hi, Horton!
Oh, Jojo, hello. Kid, now that I've got you, I'm never gonna let you go. I'll shelter and guard you, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how.
Ah! Ah! Huh?
How did you get here?
You can't run away from a sour kangaroo. Palm Beach to Pittsburgh to Kalamazoo. And you with your egg and your tree and your nest. I'm making a sour citizen's arrest.
Wait, stop. Where are you taking me?
Well, Horton, we're taking you back. You're gonna be going in style for talking to a vet and sitting on a net.
You're gonna be
put
on trial.
Order, order, order in the court.
Order, 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 order in the court.
The defendant is charged with talking to a spec, disturbing the peace, and loitering on an egg.
Your Honor, this clover is Exhibit A. There, who's here, there, there are who's here, smaller than the eye can see.
Biggest black hole in the jungle, and no!
It's true, sir, here's who's sir, he's a who and so is she.
Biggest black hole in the jungle, and no!
Order, order, order in the court.
Hall of the stand, the star witness versus Horton the elephant. Raise your right hand and swear!
I swear that he's the biggest blind fool in the jungle, and no, and a mother makes you know. Biggest blind fool
just
in
a
the
fool, fool, fool.
And a mother like me should know. Judging him trunk to toe, you better thank. Oh, please, throw him in the blank.
Talking to a spec, to a spec it does.
Objection!
Overrule! Sitting on an egg.
Objection?
Overrule. Talking to a spec.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful 100%. You can throw me in jail, lock me up in a zoo, but I won't desert my egg, and I will not abandon who. These who's, sir, win or lose, sir, whether you believe or not. They're here, they live in fear, and I'm the only friend they've got. You can do what you want with me, Your Honor, and I won't question why. But please save who? The tiniest planet in the sky.
Based on the evidence, I have no choice but to order the defendant, Horton the elephant, remanded to the Newell Asylum for the criminally insane. And as for the dust bag,
ooh, that dust bag.
And as for the dust bag,
ooh, that dust bag. And as for the dust bag, that we will boil in a hot steaming kettle of hazelnut nut oil.
Boil it? Oh no! No, that you can't do! It's all full of persons. We'll prove it to you. Mr. Mayor. Oh, please, Mr. Mayor. You've got to prove now that you really are there. So ring every doorbell and send out the word. Make every who holler. Make every who heard.
Boil.
Attention all who's. We've got to be heard. There's no time to lose. So send out the shout.
Make it loud. Make it clear.
Now surely you heard. There was a bell. Now all of you surely heard that very well.
I heard no small voices, and you didn't either.
Boil it.
Don't give up. I believe in you all. A person's a person no matter how small. And you very small persons will not have to die if you make yourselves heard, so please, try!
Boil it!
We are here!
We are here!
Now just for a moment, young Jojo looked grim. The fate of the Hoosh rested squarely on him. But then came a think, a peculiar new word, the kind of word no one ever had heard.
We are here! We are here!
Stop!
Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I mean? They made themselves heard, though they still can't be seen.
They've proved they are persons, no matter how small.
and their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
Yes, true, yes, how true, said the sour kangaroo. And from now on, you know what I'm planning to do? I'm going to protect them with you. And the young kangaroos by her side said, me too.
Their troubles were ended. They hailed his grace.
Yeah!
And JoJo was honored as thinker nonstop.
Now all JoJo's thinks would forever be heard.
Including this think.
Why, she looks just like me, except for the wings.
And except for the voice, because that's how a bird sings.
Oh, Gertrude, what will I do? I am slow, I am fat. All I know is the earth. She'll need much more than that.
I have wings. Yes, I can fly. You teach her earth, and I will teach her sky.
Just call my name, and I'll see you through. One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Who believes in you?
Their adventures were over. And the sky became
pink!
And what happened next?
Well, what do you think?
Oh, the things you can think. Think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare. When your things have run dry, in the blink of an eye, there's another think there. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find. All the things you can think,
all the things you can think,
all the things you can think, when you think about Suze, when you think about Suze, when you think about Suze, 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 Suze.
Thank you.
people you haven't seen on stage, but deserve a lot of thanks and credit. Without them, the play wouldn't be nearly as good.
Unfortunately, we don't have the time to thank everyone who deserves it individually, but a very special thanks to all the people who gave up their time to
scenery, costumes, makeup, and set design. Parent chaperoning and concession stands. Playing in the awesome band. The backstage crew. And thanks also to all the performing staff. Now, an extra special thanks so much to the five amazing people who put four long, non-stop months of hard work into making the Seussical even better.
To Ms. Belizia for co-coordinating the dance steps and keeping everyone's spirits high.
To Ms. Jacoby for all the co-coordinating, the dancing, and keeping all of us organized.
To Ms. Reisman for staying endless weekends and late nights and being so devoted and in charge of props, costume, and set design.
To Ms. Bradshaw for teaching the whole cast their many songs and lines and conducting the band.
Last but definitely not least, to Mr. Cohen for maintaining order, humor, and directing this entire play.
Think of an elephant up in a tree.
Think of a person too tiny to see.
Think of a bird with a one-feathered tail.
Going on adventure down a dangerous trail.
Think of a bird who flies off on a spree.
Think of a kangaroo, sad as can be.
Think of a general crazy for war.
Think of something horrible and hairy.
Something sinister and scary that you've never dared to think of before.
Think of nobody here, and the feeling of fear, and the darkness of night. Ooh. All alone in your room, as you're facing your doom.
Think a glimmer of light.
Ah.
But I hope you're prepared to be scarier than scared.
Cause this ain't Mother Goose.
Danger's right on the brink.
When you think about Seuss,
an unusual story will soon be unfurled of an elephant trying to save a small world and a boy from that world who has things just like you.
Just think!
From the planet of Who.
And the smallest of small.
To the jungle of Newell.
And the largest of all.
You think and 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 think.
Just think!
Oh, the things you can think.
Think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare.
When your things have run dry, in the blink of an eye, there's another thing there.
If you open your mind,
oh, the things you will find,
lining up to get loose.
Oh, the things you can think.
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 When you think about Seuss.
When you think about